Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I get so many of you guys asking me about when is it age appropriate to start medical school or to become a doctor? And so many of you guys are worried about starting families or if you have a family already, how it's going to work. Is it worth it? And what are the pros and cons? So I thought I'd get together a video for you guys to help you decide if graduate medicine is the best thing for you. And before we get into the video, I just wanted to say thank you for Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics including illustration, design, photography, videos, freelancing, and more. It's for creative and curious people like yourself, and it's great for beginners, pros, and masters. Their classes fit your schedule and skill level. And members get unlimited access to thousands of inspiring classes with hands-on projects and feedback from a community of millions. It's curated specifically for learning. I recently joined the class on Finding Instagram Success by Taylor Lauren, all about growing your Instagram account. There are no ads and they're always launching new premium classes, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. And it's less than £10 a month with an annual subscription. So now that we got that part of the way, I wanted to start off the video by saying, if you're thinking about graduate medicine and you have just come out of another degree, or you're actually in another career and you're thinking of going back into education to study medical school, it seems as though whatever you are doing or whatever you've just completed isn't satisfying you. And the reason you're thinking about medical school is to change your career path into something that you enjoy. So the first thing I'd say when people worry about changing their career and if they're too old to start medicine is to think about, would you rather spend years in a field of work that you're not completely happy with, that doesn't give you job satisfaction, or to take a few years out, complete extra education and to enter a field of work like medicine that is actually going to make you happy and enjoy going into work until your retirement age? So that leads on to the first thing that we have to factor in, and that is the amount of years of training. Now, as a graduate medicine is 4 years as opposed to 5 to 6 years that undergraduate students will have to do. Now, these 4 years are pretty jam-packed because the first 3 years are condensed into two, meaning there's a lot of work to cover, shorter summer holidays. So if you are struggling financially, which we'll be getting onto, you might find it difficult to work alongside your degree to fund things. So just as a perspective, if you're thinking about hospital medicine, the journey goes like this. So you'll have 4 years of medical school, followed by 2 years of foundation training, followed by a further 3 years of internal medical training, and then a further 4 years of specialty training. So if we do a rough calculation, so that's 13 years to become a consultant from the point that you start medical school. However, remember that once you complete medical school, you'll be working as a doctor. Just because you haven't yet become a consultant or the top of your specialty, it doesn't mean you're not going to enjoy what you're doing. And I think that's something that many people get bogged down by. They think about the number of years it takes to become a consultant or the number of years it takes to become a GP and totally forget the work up to that position. So currently myself, I'm in training to be a GP. The GP training program is 3 years after foundation years. So that will be a total of 9 years to become a GP from the point that you start medical school. But again, once you graduate, you start work as a doctor, you'll be practicing the career that you have wanted to do. And even though you haven't got to the stage or the specialty that you really enjoy, you're still practicing it and it's great. Second point is, if you're going to be applying to university as a graduate student, you've already got so many skills that you can bring on board with you. So graduate students are known to have better communication skills, better studying skills, better organizational skills, which means that The actual university program for you shouldn't be too difficult. The third point I wanted to get onto, and is a big topic for many, is finance. Now, there are lots of things that factor into this. For example, where your medical school is based. Are you going to be paying rent, or are you going to be traveling from home? And also depends on if you're going to be entering the four-year graduate entry program or if you're going to be entering the undergraduate program as a graduate. So this is probably due to be updated, but currently the tuition fees are around £9,250. So in your first year of graduate medicine, you only really need to pay just over £3,000, and the rest of your tuition fee, you can apply for a tuition loan from Student Finance England, which is a finance company that gives out loans to students. And then in your second, third and fourth year, the NHS itself will pay over just £3,000 for your tuition, and the rest is covered again by the tuition fees from Student Finance England. So if you add all of those together and consider taking a tuition loan, then you're only really paying just over £3,000 for your whole university degree. Obviously not factoring in things like maintenance costs and rent and travel and that sort of stuff. Now, these change a little bit if you're doing an undergraduate course. You are responsible for covering the tuition fee for the first 4 years, and the NHS covers your tuition fee for the last year. So this means that if you get into an undergraduate degree as a graduate student, you're going to be under a greater financial burden. But again, everyone's circumstances are different. You may have some savings aside. You may have been planning for this for a while, and all of the financial sides are okay for you. And if you've got other things to factor in, such as childcare, there are also loads of grants, bursaries and scholarships available, both from the NHS and from the university directly. So those are also things to consider when you're getting your numbers straight. Now on to the fourth point, which is location. If you have to be in a particular location because the rest of your family is there, children are in school, your partner is working in that particular city, then traveling to a medical school that's outside of your area can be difficult. So you may be restricted in choosing medical schools in the immediate area. But if you want to increase your chances of getting into a medical school, you might want to consider choosing other universities outside of your immediate area. Particularly if you're applying in London, the competition rates are pretty high. So you might want to apply for some that are outside of London to increase your chances of getting in. But obviously, again, this is based on your personal circumstances. One thing that is helpful though, is that when you graduate from medical school and you're applying for your foundation years 1 and 2, if you have children in a particular school and they're already in a routine and you know they're set in their location, then you can ask the deaneries to place you automatically in that area without having to worry about your SJT scores to rank that deanery. As far as I'm aware, this doesn't apply if, for example, your partner works in that particular city and you just want to be there because it's going to be difficult for them to move. It's mainly for things like dependent children and if you're a carer for an adult. And I wanted to finish off with the consideration of the retirement age. So on average, doctors are retiring at the age of 65. So as a rough figure, say if you started medical school at the age of 30, 31, and you completed it at the age of 35, you've still got 30 years of your career ahead of you to practice medicine. So although it might seem that you're joining the party a bit later than everyone else, actually, you've got so many years ahead of you to really enjoy the path that you've chosen. So basically, what I'm trying to say is that there are loads of factors to consider, and it's not a straightforward decision. I really appreciate that. But if it is something that you're thinking of doing, then really go for it. You know, you can only apply and see what happens. And even if you get a place and you decide that it's not going to work for you and your setup and your family, then you can just continue as you were doing previously. But the worst thing is living with regrets or wondering what would have happened if you had taken that chance and applied. For anyone who's wondering about my story, so just as a very brief, but I've got a whole video on this, I did medicine as a graduate entry student on an undergraduate course. I failed to get into medicine twice, and I got in on my third attempt. So I was very chuffed when I finally got in. And there's loads of factors as to why I feel like I didn't get in the first two times I applied. But now I'm a GP trainee and I've completed my first year already. Currently I'm on maternity leave and I'm going back to work in June. So I would have 2 years equivalent of work to complete before I become a fully qualified GP. But in the meantime, I'm going to enjoy the training, enjoy being around my other colleagues, and enjoy my daughter who joined our family in July. So hopefully that was informative for you guys. If you have any questions, please pop them in the questions and comments below, because I do answer all of them. And if you have anything that you're stuck with or if you're worried about, then just drop me a message and I'll be happy to guide you or to help you. I can't really answer any specific personal questions, but I can try my best to guide you guys. And whilst you're here, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button as well. It really helps my channel and my videos reach people like yourself. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram. My name on Instagram is the junior doc. And thanks again for Skillshare for sponsoring this video. I'll drop all of the details for how to sign up for your membership in the description and the comments so you can join classes for yourself. I'll see you in my next video, guys. Bye.